of a very popular educational television series called Where in the World is Carmen Sandiego? Millions of students have learned about geography and world cultures by watching this TV series. About 5 years ago, I started a new project called Kids on Earth. I visit students in their schools in countries all over the world, and I ask them questions about their lives, their plans for the future, and I record those interviews, and then I post them online free for everybody all over the world. Every interview basically provides a platform for a child or a teenager to tell the world what matters. That's unusual. Kids talk about being the first human on Mars, the world's biggest aquifer. It's in Paraguay. Which I learned from a child, whether dad will return from a day working in a coal mine and listening to him cough, whether humans ought to eat animals, learning a second language, addiction, violence, coding in Python, diabetes in the family, also making sticky toffee pudding, the connection between a person's name and their identity, life-threatening air pollution in New Delhi and now in Salt Lake City in the United States as well, and what to do if a career as a ballerina doesn't work out. Also, why it's a bad idea to be an illegal immigrant. Many of the kids are 10, 11, 12, 13 years old. They come from rich, middle-class, and poor backgrounds, urban, suburban, rural, from Mauritius, Egypt, Uganda, Brazil, Paraguay, Uruguay, Chile, Bulgaria, Sweden, Slovenia, Kosovo, India, Cambodia, Moldova, Mongolia. The list goes on, and we're hoping that you guys will help increase this list because we want to continue to interview, and we're doing that via Zoom now. The next ones coming up are Cameroon, Kazakhstan, and maybe your country too. So recent interviews have tended to focus on more serious subjects because that's what's on kids' minds, personal and public health, climate change and extreme weather, and people not being fair to one another. That's probably the biggest topic. As a rule, kids don't learn much about these subjects in school, and teachers aren't much help because they haven't been trained to teach these subjects. As a result, kids learn from one another and on their own. Parents tend to know even less, in part because they're busy, and in part because they haven't been taught either. And yet, health, climate change, and equality are becoming the most important topics of the 21st century. For a related project called Reinventing School, I've interviewed about 200 teachers, education professors, policy leaders, and students. The problem is clear. School, curriculum, and learning are stuck in an intractable 20th century model that leaves almost no room for 21st century topics. School needs to change in a big way. And if school will not or does not change or cannot change, we're all left to learn about topics that matter on our own. We can do better. Children and teenagers can clearly explain how, why, and what matters most, but we don't listen. We need to listen. That's why, in connection with the UN Declaration, Kids on Earth will continue to interview, record, and post interviews with young people all over the world, so children and teenagers have at least one meaningful platform, one place where their ideas can be heard. And I will continue to focus my scholarly and activist efforts on rethinking school for the 21st century for over a billion students in primary and secondary school. Our shared concerns about public health, personal health, sustainable environment, engaged communities, and respect must become the highest priorities in our schools, our homes, our communities, and our lives. Thank you, Jena Declaration, for opening a powerful means to collaborate on topics that matter, especially for the 2.4 million children and teenagers on Earth whose ideas, concerns, and lives must be the center of every conversation. If you'd like to collaborate, please find me at www.hblumenthal.com. Thank you.